Friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you few very interesting basics regarding OSI model in computer network. See, OSI means Open System Interconnect Model. That is a reference model by which any computer can communicate inside computer network. So previously we have already discussed about what is computer network, right? It is a set of collection of nodes connected with links. So here nodes are computer, that you can say. Those computers can communicate with each other with this model. Communicate means what? They can share their information with each other. So all the computers can share information with each other with this model. So let me explain you first how many basics are there with OSI model. So OSI model, that is a reference model for computer network. It was developed way back in 1970s and 1980s. It is based on bunch of protocols, and OSI model is a layered system. So here you should know, my dear students, there are well-defined protocols which is there inside OSI model, and those protocols are structured as per layered system. Layered system means what? There were total 7 layers inside OSI model. Each layer is having well-defined protocol. In this playlist of computer network, I'll explain you each and every protocols in great detail so that you can understand how exactly all the protocols are functioning. But before you go for understanding of functioning, you should know how exactly those protocols are there, right? Once you understand how those protocols are there, you can easily understand how those protocols are functioning. So first of all, you should understand this. See, OSI model, that is based on layered system. There are total 7 layers. Each layer is having well-defined protocols. See, OSI model explains how computers can communicate inside computer network irrespective of operating system. See, if you talk about operating systems of computer, then there are varieties of operating system. Like you may have Windows operating system. For Apple computers, you may have Mac operating system. Here we can use Macintosh operating system, we may have Linux operating system. So with varieties of computer, operating system changes, but OSI model is well defined. So by OSI model, we can communicate with any operating system computers, right? Like the person who is having Mac operating system can send data to the person who is having operating system based on Windows or Android, right? So here there is no boundaries based on operating system. Any computer with any operating system can communicate as per OSI model, right? Current computer network models like TCP/IP is also based on OSI model. Right now in 2023, if you see which model is there inside computer network, then you will be frequently observing TCP/IP model is working. So TCP/IP model, that is also based on OSI model only. So in future coming video, I'll explain you how exactly comparison is there in between OSI model and TCP/IP model. So all the models which are futuristic models, that is also based on OSI model only, right? Here, computer can be desktop, laptop, smartwatch, server, etc. It can be any device which can send and receive the data. So here, first of all, you should know what is computer. Computer can be laptop, desktop, that you know. But computer can be mobile. Computer can be smartwatch. Computer can be server. So technically you can say computer is a device which can send and receive the data. And inside computer network, we are talking about computers communication, right? So first of all, you should know what is computer in computer network, right? So technically we say it as a node. And in my previous videos, I have already told you there can be two categories of nodes: end nodes and intermediary nodes, right? So here those nodes are computer and they can communicate with each other as per this model. And again, let me tell you, it is a layered structure. OSI model is having a layered structure. 7 layers are there. Each layer is having well-defined protocols, right? Now let me give you one example in which you will be able to understand how computers are communicating. So for example, if I say here I'm having client server network, right? So peer to peer and client server network, For that, I have already made one video. You just go through it. Let me take one example where here one client is there, and this client is writing www.google.com in its browser. So what will happen? This client will be requesting web page data from the Google. Let us say here server of Google is there. So client will be requesting that data that will go to that medium, and then it will reaches to Google. Once Google receives that data, Google will give data based on web page, and that will reaches to client. So that is how things will happen. But this is not that simple. See, Google is not directly connected to you. When you write anything in URL, it will be routed via many intermediary nodes. Like nodes means what? Computer. Like router will be node. So that will be intermediary node. So when you write anything, that will go to Google via many intermediary nodes. So how that is happening as per OSI layers, let us try to understand that. So here, let us say here I am having one computer, and here we are having Google server. And in between these two, let us say only one intermediary node is there. Practically, there will be many intermediary nodes, but for simplicity, I am just taking one intermediary node, right? So what will happen? You see here, user will write www.google.com in its web browser. So what will happen? That data of web page that will be requested by user, now that will go to router. Via router, it will go to Google server. Now once Google server receives that request, now based on that request, Google server will respond to the data. Now it will again go back to router, and it will reaches to computer. But how it will happen via OSI layers? Let us try to understand that. So you see, there are total 7 layers, right? See, here I'm not going to explain you how exactly all the layers are there. In next video, I'll explain you each and everything along with examples based on how layers are there. But here, my goal is to explain you how communication is happening via OSI model, right? In next video, I'll explain you how layer by layer communication is happening. But first, let us try to understand how communication is happening. So see, with this computer, you are having web browser, right? So that comes under the category of application layer. So here, user will be writing data in application, which is web browser. Now, one by one layer, that data that is getting translated into another segment. Like you see, from application to presentation, you will be converting that data into binary. Here, we are also providing data compression and security. After that, it goes to session layer, where session management will happen. After that, it will go to transport layer, where segmentation will happen. Segmentation means here data will be there in terms of large file. Here data will be there in terms of segments. From transport layer, data will be given to network layer, where network layer will convert that segments into packets, right? And from network layer, data will go to data link layer. Now from packets to data will be converted into frames, and those frames, now that will be given to physical layer. So in physical layer, you may be having any wireless link or wired link, right? So here you can have Ethernet cable, here you can have optical cable, here you can have Wi-Fi. So based on that, here physical layer will give signal over here, right? Now that signal will reaches to router. Now first of all, you should know what is router. Router is 3-layer device, right? So that data of physical layer that will be received by physical layer of router. Now that will go to data link layer. So that is getting converted into what? In data link layer, it is getting converted into frames. Now that frames again is getting converted into what? It is getting converted into packets. Now that packets that is there regarding network layer, you see. So network to network, it is getting matched. So router is having 3 layers only. Now see, this is what happening in between computer to router. But now router will have to give it to what? It will have to give it to Google server. So now this packet which is there with this link, now that is getting translated into packets of this link. Means now, as per this routing, now packets are getting translated again. Then it is getting converted into frames of data link layer, and then again it will be given to physical layer. Now the data which is there over here in this physical layer, that is regarding this link. Now again this data will reaches to server node. Now server will be converting this physical data into frames over here in data link layer. Now this frames of server, now that is getting converted into packets. Packets are getting converted into segments. Segments are converted into data again over here at application layer inside Google server. So now Google will come to know, okay, one user is asking for some web data over here. Now again Google will respond to that, and Google will give data of that request, right? So that data again will go to presentation session transport, and then it will come to physical layer. Again it will go like this, and it is getting reach over here, right? So that is how things are happening. Now here you might be thinking like, this is bit typical. Right now you just consider this in this way. There are total 7 layers. This user will be requesting as per application to present to session to transport to network to data link to physical. Now from physical it will go to wire or wireless link. Now it will reaches to node. It may be intermediary node. If it is not intermediary node, it will be communicating like this, right? Directly to physical. But here intermediary node like router is there. So it will have to go via this path, right? And it will reaches to Google server. Now Google will respond in same way like this, right? So first of all, here there are many questions which is coming in competitive examination. Like they may ask you, there are total 20 packets that is going via one intermediary node, and that is a router. So how many times data link layer comes into the picture? Again, try to understand this. What is the question? 20 packets are forwarded by user via one intermediary node, that is router. So how many times data link layer comes into the picture? So you see, as if 20 packets are happening, then first you need to understand for one packet. So for one packet, you see what is happening. One time request comes over here, then it is going like this. So when request goes one time, at the time, four time data link layer comes into the picture. So for 20 packets, how many times request goes through data link layer? Four times. That is a request. Now when it comes to delivery, at the time again, four times for one packet, that request will go through this data link layer, right? So that is how things are happening. So there can be question like this, like how many times data link layer will come into the picture, how many times network layer will come into the picture, right? And I have told you, intermediary node can be router, it can be switch, it can be hub, it can be repeater. So first of all, for router you should know it is layer 3 device. Layer 3 device means what? There can be three layers: network, data link and physical layer, right? Likewise, let me go out of the picture. The reason is I would like to show you some other data, right? Like you see, when it comes to router, it is layer 3 device. So there are three layers over here, right? You see, as if it is a case of switch for intermediary node, then it can be layer 2 or layer 3 device, right? So in question you will be given like switch is there as per layer 2 device. When it comes to bridge, it is layer 2 device, in which there will be physical and data link layer. When it comes to hub or repeater, it is layer 1 device, right? So there will be physical layer only. So many of the times you will maybe getting question based on intermediary node. At a time, first of all, you should know inside intermediary node how many layers are there as per OSI layer, right? And then you will be able to understand how propagation is happening, right? So now, my dear students, in next video I'll explain you entire process of data forwarding from user to server, right? And that I'll explain you by practical example using Wireshark software. So that will give you more clarity regarding how exactly things are happening inside. Still, if anything that you like to share it with me, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.